Yeah, Jolene, that surveillance footage you're about to see is crucial in this investigation. Bethany PD tells me the man appears to be on drugs and then becomes lifeless while in handcuffs.
A quiet Monday night quickly interrupted when a stranger covered in blood arrives on Lindsay Townsend's driveway. The man screaming and banging on cars.
He was hallucinating.
Townsend's roommate walks over to help when that man, Jason Yahola, starts swinging.
I don't know what he's on, but he's on some truck.
Yahola walks out of frame where police say he took a nosedive into the concrete. His bleeding body stumbles back into Townsend's front yard, his arms and limbs flailing.
They believe that he was having a reaction to drugs.
And they didn't even ask him any questions if he was hey, what's your name? Are you okay? Like, they just immediately got on top of him and arrested him.
Bethany police say that's protocol.
For the suspect's safety and for his safety.
Then Yahola's body goes limp. Officers giving him Narcan and performing CPR. 8 minutes later, an ambulance arrives. A crowd of first responders try to bring Yahola back to life. 15 minutes passed before he's loaded up and rushed to a nearby hospital where he was pronounced dead.
We don't know at this point if he had signs of life in that front yard or not.
A trail of blood still left behind on Townsend's car and inner lawn, an unsettling reminder of the man who lost his life.
A preliminary medical examiner report shows us that all of the physical trauma to Yahola happened before officers got there, and we are still waiting for the toxicology report and that initial responding officer. Again, he's back on the job. Reporting live in Bethany, Peyton Yeager, Oklahoma's News 4.